Riviera Yachts has had a long successful run with its SUV line of yachts, and now I am on the latest launch, the 645 SUV. This is the flagship of the fleet. Join me as I do a full sea trial and performance evaluation. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll start at the helm and notice that the captain's chair is center mounted in the boat, and it's separated from the observer station by this side mount control station. It has the Humphrey interceptor controls, then the engine controls, the autopilot control station, and the controls for the forward screens right alongside that. And all of these are comfortably in a position where they can be operated from the seated position. I really like that. The observer station has space in between the two seats so we can access those as we walk around from behind. A little bit interesting that we can't get to those screens on the far side from this position, but that brings the two observer stations into play because they become an active participant in operating the boat, so I really like that. Comfort meets luxury on these seats. Leather, ultra leather, and suede. Adjustable fore and aft, up and down, and reclined for the captain. The others get up and down and fore and aft. They also have individual flip-up bolsters and flip-down armrests. There's a flip-down footrest only for the captain's seat and then additional footrest forward. I'd like to see the flip-down footrest for the observer's seats as well. Now let's move to the helm console. Three 22-inch screens, that's optional. Standard would be 17-inch. The lower panel, the twin engine displays, compass, a little bit hidden out of sight, but that's okay because we're probably going to be using the screens to plot our courses with anyway. Steering wheel is mounted to a tilt base. C-zone control. We talked about the controls on the panel over next to the helm seat. I like that there are climate control vents to both sides of the console. We also have the Seakeeper control station over here. And there's a Fusion stereo way over to the side, more for the observers to handle. Electrical switches are right underneath the steering wheel. And of course, we have the searchlight controls right alongside the steering wheel. We have the joystick, which has also got the control for the optional stern thruster. And this has also got the optional position keeping. Now, the positioning of that joystick is such that I can stand next to the helm, have my eye out the back as I'm backing into a slip, and bring us right in. This also gives me quick access to the side door and the side decks, or right out the back door where I can get to the stern stations. Standard is one station, optional is two. This hatch gives us access to the back side of the engine room and lazarette storage. 13-inch cleats mounted to the quarters, and look at this chafing gear. 50-amp shore cords are concealed underneath the bulwarks to both port and starboard. We can make our way to the bow from either the port or starboard side. Starts with a 9-inch step at the cockpit. Come forward. Another 9-inch step. And another. Right here in the side deck, diesel fuel with gauges right alongside showing the digital level for both diesel and water. I like that they show the levels. Bulwarks at this level come up 17 inches, rails tap out at 36. Right at midship, we have another 9-inch step. Continuing on forward, got a cleat aft and then another midship cleat, 13 inches. Fully forward, a Muir windlass handling 80 meters of all chain road as a chain stopper, leading out to stainless steel swivel holding the ultra anchor, 60 kilograms or 132 pounds. That goes out to the anchor roller just below the pulpit. Road accesses to the starboard side, to the port side, we've got a bin with the salt and fresh water washdown and the remote control for the windlass. Notice how this whole area is dammed and recessed and cut off from this aft area so that when we're hosing off this whole space, it won't get onto this bow area. So three-piece windshield, the two side ones are 49 by 49, the center is 49 by 52, and above there's a 32-inch brow that hangs out, and that's what really gives Riviera Yachts their muscular look, that beefy look that it can just plow through anything. I really like the strength that it gives it.
Now, there are two ways to access this engine room. One is right here in the upper mezzanine, and I can't help but notice that Riviera made this hatch a little bit oversized, so if you want to put things like stand-up paddle boards in, you can slide them in right through here. The second way is through the master stateroom, through the master head, and we have either an optional crew quarter or a storage space. In this case, we have the crew quarters with a single berth, laundry, and a crew head. And right behind me is the entrance to the engine room. Nicely laid out engine room right at the entrance. Two 29 kW generators, one to port, one to starboard. Air conditioning systems are all at the top and they're nicely labeled. Salon, master cabin, port cabin, everything in this engine room is nicely labeled. Of course, the highlights being the dual man V12 1550 horsepower engines. Standard engines are 1300 horsepower. Right up above, here's the entrance to the upper mezzanine area that we were at just a moment ago. Looking behind you, we can see the optional Seakeeper gyro stabilizer. To both sides of that is the water maker system. The Riviera 645 SUV has a length overall of 69 feet 8 inches, a beam of 19 feet 1 inch, and a draft of 5 feet 4 inches. With an empty weight of 88,119 pounds, 50% fuel and 4 people on board, we had an estimated test weight of 94,852 pounds. With the twin 1,550 horsepower manned V12 engines run up to 2380 RPM, our speed topped out at 35.3 knots. There's a nearly perfect power-to-weight ratio with this yacht, so once we back off on the throttles, she'll maintain 0.3 nautical miles per gallon until she falls off plane. So with that said, there's no real best cruise per se. But if we run her at the recommended 80% load at 2190 RPM, she'll cruise at an average 31.3 knots. At that speed, the combined 126.5 gallon per hour fuel burn gives her a range of 382.9 nautical miles, all while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 1,717 gallon total fuel capacity. In acceleration tests, we reach planing speed in an average 9.5 seconds, and she'll hold plane right on down to 11 knots. With the throttles pinned, we cruise through 20 miles per hour in 11.4 seconds, 30 in 15.2, and hit 40 in 22.7 seconds. As far as handling characteristics go, it always impresses me how when you come up on plane, Riviera's come up at a level attitude instead of with a big bow rise. It's nice the way they do that, and you don't lose sight of the horizon. We had calm conditions on our test day, so I really can't comment on their offshore handling capabilities. But with that said, I have driven many Rivieras through less than ideal conditions, and I've had no reason to find anything to criticize. At the aft side of the mezzanine area is the main breaker panel and battery switches, so everything can be turned on before we enter the boat. Right at the entrance to the galley, there's a C-zone control panel that allows us to control every electrical component on the boat, whether it's 110 or 12 volt, and we can even program modes into this. We could do a whole video on this in and of itself. There's another control panel at the helm, and we can control everything as well by an iPad. And here's another thing I noticed. Anytime you need to get access behind a panel, it drops down to give you much easier access. That's a thoughtful touch on Riviera. And I also noticed that there's a Siren monitoring hub. Not only do you get the uncompromising support of the Riviera team, you also get 2 years of Siren monitoring for your boat. So you'll get to see the Siren monitoring of your bilge pumps, your electrical system, your shore power, and access to that on your iPad or your smartphone for up to 2 years. So that is just another way that Riviera gives you peace of mind, and that is my full sea trial and performance evaluation of the 645 SUV from Riviera. For BoatTest.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.